IISD Reporting Services is here in Lima, Peru for the UN Climate Change Talks, covering selected side events. On Tuesday, December 2nd, delegates discussed technology transfer through the Climate Technology Center and Network, CTCN. The CTCN, the operational arm of the UNFCCC Technology Mechanism, started their implementation in early 2014. CTCN helps provide developing countries with the technical assistance they need to mitigate and adapt to climate change.
It's been an exciting year. We've gone from zero requests to over 20 now that are being responded to, and numerous others under discussion. We've provided capacity building activities to over 100 countries in all to really build the capacity to identify priorities and needs for technologies related to climate and to be able to submit technology requests to the CTCN.
Our core services is that technical assistant, this response process. But we also want to be very strong in providing and sharing information and knowledge.
The CTCN is focused on building South-South collaboration and fostering knowledge in developing countries.
We are providing information and knowledge, but also we are learning from other experiences. We are learning from these South-South and North-South collaboration projects. So it is very important to work together towards the knowledge, the technology transfer and development. In this case, Ecuador is being benefited from this network collaboration.
It's a two-way mechanism. We can ask to other countries, to other institutions for help. In some topics that we don't have so much experience. In the other side, we can offer our own expertise.
Academics, civil society, and the private sector are also involved in the Climate Technology Network and often provide crucial advice to countries on the ground.
And we hope to support the network by providing technical assistance on mobilizing private sector finance into the network.
In Lima, the CTCN launched a new online knowledge management portal that serves as a gateway to CTCN services and makes information on climate technology more widely available.
The COP, in its mandate to create the CTCN, really identified the sharing of knowledge as being crucial to the success of our work. And so we've been working over the past year to build a knowledge management system that will provide the types of information that are the most useful to our national designated entities, which are the CTCN focal points, but also to developing countries in general.
They're providing a system which is not limited to their own website. So, you know, often people, what people see initially is a website. But what's behind that is a whole architecture that links in information from many other partners, that provides the own information, the CTCN information, to other partners, and therefore creates a bigger space of information from which the client can draw.
The CTCN hopes that all stakeholders will join them in the future of technical cooperation, either as knowledge partners or as countries seeking assistance.
Yes, we can enhance, yes, we can embellish, yes, we can improve. But again, unless the countries take advantage of this, we won't know how those improvements ought to go. So instead of looking at the next best thing, let's look at this best thing and make it work.
Additionally, we'll be focusing on regional expertise trainings and then continuing to build linkages for our knowledge portal. So really trying to seek greater partnerships and to highlight the work of other organizations in climate technologies.
Watch out for more coverage of the side events at COP20, brought to you by IISD Reporting Services.